one of the saddest ones of anything I've ever done. Especially if I get this last act. Tanner score. Man, that is so sad. Literally 600 points just vanished into thin air. Why the fuck did I do that? It was so stupid. Dude, I just completely threw the run doing that. I'm such a fucking idiot. Like that in this room. The green was bad. It's one or the other, man. It's so fucking hard to get decent whammy on both of those for some reason. Thank you. get it? Oh my god, I got it! Holy shit, that is a fucking score! That is a score! Fuck yes, dude! Almost makes all this bullshit actually worthwhile for a change. Soak it in. Soak it in, bitch. You earned it this time. God damn. I'm sorry, Andy, but you have been kicked out of the house. Pretty crazy ticks, though. I mean, Fug has even better ticks, of course. But he has one less squeeze, which, you know, you can do some path adjustments to make ticks a lot better. Also, I think that my ticks were probably shit because of the third act. And also, this runs first act. This runs first act, it definitely dropped ticks, but it still ended up with more than the bigger squeeze path using the traditional blue first act, so... Wow, man, I am super glad to have closed this out for a change. I had that first run where I hit the first two squeezes, and I had... There's no point in even rehashing this, because I'm sure I'm going to show it, but, like, I'm sitting there, I did the first phrase whammy for the last act, and I was just like, that was terrible, like, don't go for this, you're not even going to close to make it. And at the last second, I was just like, oh yeah, fuck it, man, let's go all out. And I lost, like, 600 on that last act. Fucking terrible. The only consolation is that that would have been a 300 run. With some extra ticks, I think, but probably not many with that shitty whammy I got on that run. So I guess I'll go over the TAS findings. First act, nearly ideal, is possible. It is a 7-frame window. As I discussed in the heart-shaped box video, those frame windows shrink incredibly fast when you are dealing with multiple whammies, and this act, just like that song's last act, has 7 whammies, except this act's 7 whammies are incredibly hard to optimize. Oh my god, this is the hardest whammy I think I've ever come across in any of these songs, particularly on that first act, but all throughout this song. This song is a fucking whammy hellscape. And on top of that, my god, man. I just kept overlapping front ends like it was my fucking job. But yeah, absolutely brutal this experience was. Total of about between 6 and 7 hours. Which, to be fair, I've had a lot worse, but I'm also a lot better than I was during some of those older grinds, so regardless of the time difference in some of my worst grinds, this was really bad. Anyway, first act with this adjustment, this is kind of like a weird hybrid between the bigger squeeze and the nearly ideal. The nearly ideal act, man, like, I have no idea if that will ever be pulled off. That is fucking ridiculous. Even with the fact that you can use extended hit window on it and you can't on the following orange, it's still, ugh, man. Extended hit window is very much not a free 3 frames, man. It is incredibly hard to optimize even one, especially 2 frames using extended hit window, so there's a reason I choose to go for certain hopo squeezes and songs that are not extended hit window usable. So that's all to say, there is an extra 200 plus ticks on that first act. Of course, just holding ticks in general in this song is incredibly hard, so I don't know how particularly valuable that is, but second act, really not much to say besides the specifics of it. It's an 8-frame window with perfect whammy, but of course that, you know, with 4 different whammies on it, again, that shrinks incredibly quickly, still a very hard activation. And the adjustment that I made, well, that's with the adjustment that I made, moving it back to the yellow, because it has a much bigger front end. And it's the same kind of thing, actually, as the first act where, you know, I lose extended hit window by moving it to that hammer-on, but it's still worth it, not only because the frame window was better, though that's obviously the main reason, but because it makes the act so much easier. Now, if only I could just quit sucking balls at overlapping these front ends. That would actually be useful for a change. Third act, I really don't have anything much to say besides that I was not at all looking to optimize ticks. Trying to optimize whammy for the fourth act, I mean, frame-wise, you can do it. You can get all the ticks in and get max whammy, but yeah. Doing that in a run, particularly after hitting the first two acts, ugh, nah. Fourth act is nearly ideal, is possible. I don't even know if I hit it a single time, because every time that I think I got the back end in, I overlapped the front end, and that raises the difficulty exponentially. Trying to go for that, I am satisfied where this is. For at least, at the very least, for now, I mean, I probably would have been satisfied with a 345 low 3 at this point, but yeah, where I'm sitting at now, I'm incredibly satisfied with this, but I don't even know if down the road I'll be willing to go for 345.7, let alone 0.9 on that first act. But it is possible. It's a 7-frame window, and the whammy for it, it's kind of shitty, kind of not. Again, the fact that it ends right after the third act, and you have to make sure not to overlap that first blue. Really annoying, but the sustains themselves actually have pretty generous windows, I think. And as a result, they're also buffered whammy compatible, first frame whammy, so it's actually kind of... Which, that 7-frame window I talked about for it wasn't utilizing that. So, when things are buffered first-frame whammy compatible like that, it's not like I ever try to actually utilize it, but it does just give you kind of an extra fail-safe in case you whammy early, although that's sort of tangled up in the other mechanics of buffered whammy. In that, if you're still holding the whammy down when you the frame that you start to sustain, it won't activate. So it really is kind of just a shit show. But that all is to say that you technically have like a little bit of wiggle room, I guess. And it's also kind of irrelevant overall because it only is applicable for the first sustain in a phrase like this. All the others just carry over your whammy from the previous when they're this close together. Something that I do need to talk about in this fourth act is that I learned something pretty important in that I don't understand the mechanics of this game, extended hit window, fret tricking, as well as I thought I did, because when I first tasked out the fourth act, I did it while using the extended hit window fret trick to preemptively end the oranges while accumulating all the points on them. I just did that to see if maybe that was worth doing in a run. It probably wasn't. The execution would be incredibly awkward, but I was just curious anyway. I also just assumed that would be the most secure way to make sure that I got all the whammy going through frame by frame and didn't have to make it a really big pain in the ass by seeing exactly how many ticks each sustain was worth and trying to work with it like that, because that's a really big pain. Obviously, that's what I ended up having to do by when I re-tasked that act, but all is leading up to the fact that when I first tasked the fourth act by doing that, it was a 1-frame window, the act was, and I was like, hold on, this is not right. My initial instinct when I hit the blue back end as early as possible and star power ended on the next frame, I was just like, wow, this is impossible. But then I thought for like 3 seconds, I was like, this does not reflect my experience in the game. I felt like this was pretty possible yesterday when I was messing with this. So thankfully I had a state from right as those sustains were starting, so I didn't have to like replay the song or anything. But yeah, I ended up retasking the act by letting all of the orange sustains fully play out, And that's what changed it to a 7-frame window. So, yeah, that means that when you premature end sustains like that, using the descending extended hit window fret trick, it doesn't actually accumulate all the whammy, despite accumulating all of the ticks, which is kind of weird, kind of not, though, because that's how it works with, if you, like, prematurely interrupt a sustain of the same fret, because I've come across, like, one instance of something similar that I remember anyway when I was tassing out You Really Got Me's solo act. I was thinking about this mechanic, and that activation's second star power phrase has a yellow-orange chord followed by a yellow-orange sustain chord followed by a regular orange sustain chord. And so I was like, oh, I wonder if you early strum the orange, if it just completes the chord sustain, giving you all of the star power, and then you can early whammy the orange. But when I tasked out the act, it ended up being a frame worse than by doing things on time. So that was where I kind of understand the, but at the same time, it still completes the chord sustain and gives you all of the ticks. So I guess it does make sense in that regard, but I just didn't think it followed the same logic, because this whole extended hit window fret trick thing is so bizarre and so anomalous for the vast majority of mechanics. Now, it isn't quite as simple as this, though. It isn't quite as simple as, oh, well, it's never worth using the extended hit window fret trick on descending star power sustains, because if the following, you know, it can, I think, be useful, and I've seen this myself in a TAS act, when the following note is a sustain that you can quote-unquote fudge early whammy on, and that was like the whole point of it from the get-go. This is all just kind of like a side thing that got cleared up, really, but the way I first either found or thought I found this mechanic was tassing out the first act for Sweet Child of Mine, where when I used that extended hit window fret trick descending sustain mechanic, I ended up getting an extra tick out of that first act, and that was where this all got set in motion of me thinking this is how this worked. As far as that goes, that's kind of still an unsolved mystery. It's possible that the reason that gave an extra tick was because the following sustain that I used that trick on had like a higher tempo, maybe. And so it's possible that those sustains, that sustain was just worth more star power. I guess it could also be possible that by using that mechanic, you get both a frame of whammy on the sustain that you're currently fretting and the one that you're going to. So maybe you just get like a combined, kind of like a chord. Well, that's not even a good example, because I don't even know if chords give you more star power. But yeah, that's essentially what I'm saying. Maybe you get like a combined frame of whammy by doing that. Otherwise, yeah, still up in the air. Don't know what to make of it. And I'm sick of talking about it. And last act here, this is a 14-frame window, I believe. Even that being said, with the 5 whammies leading up to it, particularly the second phrase just has these tiny hit windows, especially that first blue on the second phrase. My god. It's a really big headache still. Again, especially at the end of a run like this where you've hit multiple difficult squeezes and you've been grinding this song for a couple days, many, many hours straight. But at the end of the day, I'm really glad that I pushed for it and went and got it here. I put this song off for quite a while for a reason, just because I, from what I've heard about it and read on the Score Hero descriptions, it's a really big pain, and it definitely lived up to that. At the same time, it's opened my eyes a little bit to just how far this game has to be pushed, that I'm pretty sure nobody believed this first act nearly ideal was possible. Just by playing the song, and to get to that point where you start to feel like it even might be, you have to get so good at abusing these early whammies. And the fact that there's still two more squeezes plus ticks is frightening to me. I just took a look at the upper bound chart for pretty much the first time. I seriously doubt this second act is possible. With upper bound charts, I'm more confident in saying that because of the whole calculating first frame whammy thing that I'm pretty sure it's doing. Whereas nearly ideal acts, because of the leniency, I'm almost sure all of those are possible. It's just a matter of optimizing these insanely hard early whammies. But yeah, and the fact that just the nearly ideal path has over 100 more ticks than this is crazy. But whatever, I've looked at the song, thought about the song, and heard the song enough. The funny thing about Guitar Hero and these rhythm games is that if you actually like push yourself and want to improve at them, is that it will introduce you to so much amazing music that you never would have probably heard otherwise, and it'll make you really grateful for having experienced it. And then by the end, you'll end up hating all that same music because of how many times you hear it and what it put you through. But I still love this song, man. It's just too good.